Students, today we are going to deal with financial statement analysis. In this session, we will learn about financial statement analysis. As you have already studied about the different aspects of financial management 1, where we have studied about the elementary concepts of accounting, the definition of accounting, the fundamental and non-fundamental concepts of accounting, the rules of journal entry, how to post the transactions in ledger. Correspondingly, we have also prepared the final accounts of some of the companies, wherein we have prepared the income statement, profit loss account, balance sheet of the companies. We have also dealt with subsidiary books, like we have prepared the purchase book, the sales book, cash book. In cash book, we have also studied about one column cash book and two column cash book. We have also solved some of the numerical examples with the topics that I have already told to you just now. Now, from here, we move on to the financial statement analysis. Now, the financial statement analysis is one of the most important concepts in financial reporting. The primary objective of financial statement or financial reporting is to see or report the actual happenings or the actual state of a company. Like through the income statement, we come to know about the profit of the company, the gross profit and the net profit of the company. And through the balance sheet, we come to know about the asset and liability position of the company as on given date. However, financial reporting has got some certain limitations, and it has been subject to some manipulation of the financial data. Like here I would like to point out to the episode of Ramlingam Raju or Satyam Scam, where he window dressed the financial statements. Basically, financial reporting is one aspect of finance, whereas financial statement analysis is another aspect of finance. Mere reporting of the financial transactions does not sometimes, or you can say at times, it does not give the actual state within which a company is. For that, it is necessary to perform the financial statement analysis, where we are going to see what are the different financial statement analysis tools and techniques in this session. I have already explained about the background of financial statement analysis, so we can move on. So, what is a financial statement analysis? Financial statement analysis is basically an interpretation of the income statement and balance sheet of the company to know the strength and weaknesses of a particular company. Now, there are two tools and techniques, or there are two types of financial statement analysis. One is on the basis of material used, that is the external analysis and the internal analysis, and one is the type of operation that you are doing with the financial report, that is the horizontal analysis. In horizontal analysis, the comparative statement, we prepare the comparative statement like comparative income statement, comparative balance sheet of a company, whereas in vertical analysis, we are doing the common size statement, we are preparing the common size statement. The external analysis and the internal analysis. Coming back to the external analysis and internal analysis. External analysis means the analysis which is done by the person or the individuals who are outside to the company, it may be the creditors, the credit rating agencies, the investment bankers, and so on. Where the internal analysis is a kind of analysis of the financial statements, which is done by those individuals who are internal to the company, like managers, CEOs, and henceforth. And on the basis of modus operandi, actually we know that currently we are doing or reporting the financial statement as per the International Accounting Standard 3. So basically, the comparative statement and the common size statements is the old nomenclature. It has been, as per the IAS 3, it has been coined as horizontal analysis and vertical analysis. So this is a snapshot of how a horizontal analysis is prepared, how it is done. So basically, here we can see that the elements of the profit and loss account, has a comparison has been made in two periods. Like in one period, the net sales, cost of goods sold, gross profit, and other aspects of the profit has been compared with the same data of some another period, and the change in amount as well as the percentage is prepared. So this is one example of horizontal analysis of next. So again, this is a horizontal analysis report of the balance sheet of a company. Again, the same format that already you have prepared in the balance sheet, the same format you have followed by preparing the balance sheet of the company. Now the comparison here in horizontal analysis, the comparison between two periods has been done. First, in the third column, there will be the change in the amount, that is the absolute value, and in the last column, the percentage change of the same item is demonstrated. It will be very clear when we go on and do some numericals also on this thing, which I will be sharing you through our G Suite. Next slide. Now these are the snapshot of the different methods of financial analysis. First is the comparative statement analysis. The comparative statement analysis, basically the horizontal analysis, as you can recall now, the horizontal analysis that you did, that for a financial statement, that is for an income statement and a balance sheet of two periods is compared, one in the amount and other one in percentage. Next one is common size statement. Now common size statement is basically of two types. One is the common size income statement, another one is common size balance sheet. Third one is trend analysis. This is a time series analysis. Fourth one is the ratio analysis. This is another very important aspect of finance. It is a very core skill in finance, and I would like to remind you, or I would like to recall to you, that ratio analysis is one of the very fundamental core skill, which if you have a command over a good tool and techniques of ratio analysis, you can be or become a very good analyst. Funds flow analysis, the next. Fund flow analysis is basically a statement which is prepared for the sources and application of the funds. Cash flow analysis, the sources and a statement which shows the sources and application of cash of a company within a period. Now there is a difference. Now what is the difference between fund flow analysis and cash flow analysis? I think you should be very clear now only. The difference between fund flow and cash flow, as you can recall, that our accounting concept, the difference lies here with the accounting concept. Now you can recall that our accounting concept, we follow the accrual system of accounting, right? So the fund flow analysis is basically on the basis of accrual concept, whereas the cash concept is prepared on the basis of cash concept. Cost, volume, profit analysis, here we will be preparing a marginal cost statement where you will be calculating on the basis of the marginal cost statement. You will be preparing the profit volume, P by V ratio, break-even point and margin of safety. There is some applications also of this cost, volume, profit analysis, like make and buy decision, then plant merger decision, export decision. So all these things you will be understanding and interpreting with the help of numerical examples. So we are concluding this session now. This was just a brief introduction. From the next sessions onwards, we'll be focusing on the numerical aspects of the financial statement analysis. I'm also sharing you the PDF of the same theoretical aspect of this financial statement analysis from the Reddy and Reddy book from page number 4.2 onwards. Thank you.